Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. Going to do a real quick video because they take forever to upload. Last one took 2 hours. So what we're looking at Bitcoin is the third week of the pullback, looking for the equilibrium in the higher low to form. And everybody's really bearish, just like everybody was really bullish on the way up. It's really interesting to watch the psychology and the swing of emotions on Twitter and in the crypto universe. But we just had a month in a row, April, of all green. Now we have a month in a row of all red here in May. And we're still not giving back all that we just made in the month of April. So again, it's still in the equilibrium pattern. We are still looking for a higher low to form. And it's looking like daily oversold is where we're going to get it, because the RSI right now on Bitcoin is 32. And if we get a break of 7,000 and a little flush climax under that level, the daily RSI will be oversold. And it will be at the point where we bounced back at the beginning of April, when that higher low was set back in April. So that's what we're keeping an eye on at this point. We had the inside bars break bearish. The 4-hour time frame, RSI is hovering just above oversold. Little bear flag. We didn't really flush on the break. We dropped down to a lower low, and bulls quickly started to buy that dip, but it's a weak bounce at this point. It is a bear flag setup. And if we drop down to a lower low, 7,000 will be on the radar. And if we break 7,000 on this move, then again, the daily and the 4-hour RSI will both be oversold. As we can see, the 4-hour exponential resistance levels rejected the price. And we have a triple top, essentially, which is going to be the most important level on the bounce once it really gets going. And that's going to be here at 7,661, 7,640, 7,629. So essentially 7,629 to 7,662. We had three tops clearly reject the price, and we're going to have to see these exponential moving averages become support and see a bullish cross. And we can always look back at April. What happened in April when we saw the bottom back then? And it was a base of support. Let's see here. So a base of support. We bounced around, we formed a large equilibrium pattern, and then a huge bull break that signaled the start of the daily bull move. So big time equilibrium pattern will be on watch. We just had a big time equilibrium pattern that broke bearish, so that tells us not ready just yet. And we're patiently watching the $7,000 level, and either going to be a break of 7,000 or a break of 7,662 for the bulls to prove themselves. They have to get over that level. Ethereum is starting to catch back up to Bitcoin, not quite yet, because we haven't dropped down and broke to a lower low, but we had an inside bar break bearish here as well. At this point, I've scaled out of the vast majority of my position. I've got maybe, 20% or a little bit less than that. And I took a small loss exiting roughly in the 600 range after my average was about 618. But again, an $18 loss is very easy to make up once the bounce is for real. So at this point, I have no internet and no anything, but I do have orders placed if we do drop down, because I know that the Bitcoin daily RSI and the Bitcoin 4-hour RSI will get oversold if my orders are hit before I get internet again. So I know I'm going to get internet in 36 hours or so. And so that's just me factoring in that, you know, if Bitcoin drops down and breaks 7,000 and Ethereum drops down and breaks 545, I've got orders in the 520s, the 5 teens, and then I've got orders all the way even down in the 490s and 480s in case things get really ugly. So that's my current game plan, because I do want a position once this daily bounce does get going. We know the oversold bounce is going to happen on Bitcoin. It's just a matter of when. And I am still choosing Ethereum at this point. And it is holding up a little bit better than Bitcoin. It's just a question of, you know, if Bitcoin breaks 7,000, Ethereum is going to break 545 very likely. So let's look at the hourly RSI here. Hourly RSI on Bitcoin is oversold. 4-hour RSI just above oversold. Daily RSI just above oversold as well at 36. Litecoin on the daily time frame dropping down. Litecoin's close to breaking its weekly equilibrium bearish. And no bulls on any coin want to see that happen. It doesn't make a huge difference, but it is definitely something that I will factor in. So 109.27 is the key level to hold, and we're dropping down. We're about 7% away from that level right now. The daily chart, we had inside bars break bearish. We haven't dropped to a lower low just yet, same as on Ethereum. 115.11 is that level. Daily RSI on Litecoin is down at 35. The 4-hour RSI is not as oversold. We're sitting at 36, and the hourly RSI not as oversold as well. So it looks like another leg down is coming. We're rejecting from exponential resistance on the hourly time frame. We can see Bitcoin on the hourly time frame looking at these exponential resistances, rejected on the bounce attempt. So again, it's back to square one. Have to get the exponential resistances as support on the hourly, then the 4-hour, and then the daily if we're going to see any kind of significant move. But one step at a time, hourly is first, and have to see a more convincing bounce than this, and we have to see volume behind it. So that's where we stand. Bears still have control, watching daily oversold RSI and Bitcoin 7,000. And again, a lot of people in this bounce right now and not in positions that they want. They've either taken a loss at this point or they're sitting on a loss. But it's, again, the kind of position that I do, I'm not giving up on this bounce whatsoever. I'm just being cautious around it. But I do know that when Bitcoin does bounce on the daily time frame, you know, the oversold bounces historically. All you got to do is look back what happens when the RSI hits 30 or hits just below 30. How much upside do we see from there? And the answer is usually multiple days at the least, and oftentimes multiple weeks. So that's something that I'm keeping an eye on, and we'll see how it fares from here. Keep an eye on that 7,000 flush, and we'll see you tomorrow.